what's up? This is Blaze the Movie Fan, and I have grown sick and tired of people complaining about skits and reviews. So, I decided to make a video about it. So, without further ado, let's begin. Now, I have heard many people say that the Angry Video Game Nerd and the Nostalgia Critic have gone downhill because of skits, which is fucking stupid. Now let's start by talking about the Angry Video Game Nerd. It's fucking stupid to say that he has gone downhill because the show now focuses so much on skits, because skits have been a big part of the Angry Video Game Nerd show since the beginning. I mean, yes, he does review the games that he is talking about. I used to think that he does that, but I was wrong. However, skits have always been a major part of the show. To prove my point, I am gonna list every AVGN episode of 2006 that have skits. Let's go. Who Framed Roger Rabbit? Masters 2 and the Drunkard Who? Friday the 13th. A Nightmare on Elm Street. Now this might be few, but that's only because there were few Angry Video Game Nerd episodes released that year period. But you get my point. Skits have always been a major part of the Angry Video Game Nerd. Here's something that you would need to understand about the Angry Video Game Nerd show. It's not solely a reviewing show. I mean, sure, reviewing is a big part of the show, but it's not meant to be pure reviewing. It's meant to be for entertainment as well. And guess what? In the following fucking years, there were even more Angry Video Game Nerd episodes that had skits in them. So don't throw me that bullshit that the Angry Video Game Nerd has gone downhill because the show is now full of skits, and pretend that it hasn't been a thing since the beginning, since it has. As a matter of fact, I can here give an example of a recent Angry Video Game Nerd episode with a skit that actually works. In the Pepsi Man review, there was a character appearing that turned everything into a fucking Pepsi. It was completely relevant to the game, since the Angry Video Game Nerd was reviewing a game based on him. And the side story in the review was also very solid. I mean, sure, that video focused way more on the skits than actually reviewing the game. But honestly, so did the review of A Nightmare on Elm Street, Friday the 13th, and hell, even Super Mario Bros. 3. All those videos were more skit-driven than anything else. So if you have a problem with the recent Angry Video Game Nerd episodes having too many skits and not much reviewing, you should have a problem with the old ones doing that as well. Since it's literally nothing new. Now I'm gonna talk about the Nostalgia Critic. A lot of people complained about how the Nostalgia Critic got downhill because he put too many skits in his reviews. Now I'm not gonna address the fact that it has been part of the show since the beginning. Since unlike the Angry Video Game Nerd, the Nostalgia Critic hasn't always been mainly about skits. There were skits in his videos occasionally, but it wasn't always the case. In his early years, only a few of the Nostalgia Critic episodes had skits, and the rest of them were just plainly reviewing the movies. But I will address though what I have a problem with. Most of the people complaining about the skits in the Nostalgia Critic show don't even go into any detail on why these skits don't work. And that's really fucking frustrating. They just complain about the simple fact that there are skits and say that they came here for the review. That is fucking stupid. Since you are still getting the fucking review. Just because there is a side plot in the video with the skits doesn't mean that the reviewing person isn't there. Because it fucking is, obviously. Now, there are a few Nostalgia Critic episodes where he doesn't review the movie at all. It focuses only on skits. But these videos are the very small minority. In the majority of his reviews, he does review the movies in between the skits. Now, I could explain why the skits in the Son of the Mask or Cat in the Hat review work, but both of those videos are beyond irrelevant at this point since they are so fucking old. And I want to talk about something more relevant. Because of that, I will be explaining why a skit works in a review that's actually recent. I will explain how it works in the Spider-Man review. Now, a lot of people have pointed out how the Nostalgia Critic is wrong in assuming that people don't like the Sam Raimi's Spider-Man movies anymore. Though I would argue that's not the main point of his skit. Though, to be fair, it is understandable why people would come to that conclusion. Anyway, the main point of the skit was to show that people's opinions change with time. What you used to love in the past are things that you don't love anymore. And the same can apply the other way around. That was the point the Nostalgia Critic was trying to establish with that skit. You know, maybe the Nostalgia Critic was trying to say that people don't like the Sam Raimi's Spider-Man movies anymore. It is still very possible that he was trying to say that message. But my point that was that the main point of the skit still stands. As for how it's relevant, well, it's very simple. The Nostalgia Critic is talking about Sam Raimi's Spider-Man movies. And those people are giving their opinion on the Sam Raimi's Spider-Man movies. So, it's completely fucking irrelevant. But even if these skits were irrelevant, so fucking what? I don't think many people who critique these skits understand the point of them. The point of the skits isn't to connect to the movie video game or whatever someone is reviewing. The point of the skits is to have a side story alongside the reviews. That's it. That's the entire fucking point. So even if they are irrelevant to the movie itself, they are not irrelevant to the video overall. For example, I interact with a lot of characters in my videos that have nothing to do with the movie that I'm reviewing. But the side story is still relevant to the events going on in the video, which is the fucking point. And that's also the reason why the Irate Gamer does skit. If you want to watch reviewers that are solely reviewers, I recommend you watch Jeremy Jones or Chris Stockman. But even they have made skits in their reviews occasionally. And Jeremy Jones' review, Never Say Never, he did have a skit at one point. Oh, and Chris Stockman also made a skit in his The Dark Knight Rises review. But the vast majority of videos by both still have no skits at all. In fact, I don't think that even fucking 1% of the reviews do. But honestly, the fact that Jeremy Jones and Chris Stockman occasionally make skits in their videos does prove one thing. It's normal for reviewers to have skits. So complaining about reviews having skits is completely fucking stupid. You have reached the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.